नहीं नहीं मैं अभी अभी मैंने मेल किया है सर आपको अभी ही।
गुड मॉर्निंग कैलाश सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग मेहुल सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग निरंजन लल्लू सर।
स्टार्ट करना है कैलाश सर,
अभी टाइम है भाई,
दो मिनट में स्टार्ट करते
हैं। कैलाश सर,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
हेलो
सर। यस सर।
कैलाश सर, हु इज गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस आवर चीफ गेस्ट?
डॉक्टर कैलाश टंडेल।
ओके ओके ओके।
हेलो
मैं टक।
हाँ जी सर।
यू आर गिवन ट्रेनिंग टू टंडेल, दैट्स व्हाई यू वांट टू डू ऑल द ऑलराउंडर नाउ।
आई टोल्ड हिम दैट समबडी एल्स कुड हैव बीन असाइंड।
यस नाउ एक्सपर्ट बन गए हो।
I welcome Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. A.S. Dhawan sir. Sir, within few minutes we will start, sir, please.
No issue, I'm already on the line, no problem, take your own time.
Okay sir, thank you sir. आलेत का माणसं त्यातले किती जेवढे रॅक ठेवायचे तेवढेच तुम्ही खाली घ्या, बाकीचे सगळे खालच्या मीटर रूम मध्ये जाऊ दे।
సరే సార్, అదొకటి కొంచెం డస్టింగ్
बस एक मिनट में स्टार्ट करते हैं, वो जा रहा है, एक मेल जा रहा है इसलिए। हाँ हाँ ठीक है, एक ही मिनट।
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल, गुड मॉर्निंग डॉक्टर टंडे,
गुड मॉर्निंग।
हाँ डॉक्टर विरांजलु सर कहाँ पर है?
गुड मॉर्निंग त्रिपाठी सर।
हाँ गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग रोहल जी।
गुड मॉर्निंग त्रिपाठी सर।
अरे जादव सर गुड मॉर्निंग, एक्चुअली आई एम यूजिंग मोबाइल, ऑल फेसेस आर नॉट बीइंग अपीयर्ड।
रोहिला जी नमस्ते।
सर सर नमस्ते, वेरी नमस्ते सर, वेरी वेरी नमस्ते।
और जादव जी कैसे हैं? जादव जी, डॉक्टर जादव सर, हेलो डॉक्टर जादव सर, आप
मेहुल सर
यस सर,
यस संतोष सर, संतोष कर,
यस
कैन वी स्टार्ट?
जस्ट अ मिनट।
ओके अकनपल जी बोलिए।
हेलो
वेर इज आवर जनरल सेक्रेटरी डॉक्टर कनपाल?
गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू।
कनपाल
हेलो,
कैलाश सर,
गुड मॉर्निंग
डॉक्टर कैलाश, यू कैन स्टार्ट नाउ प्लीज,
यू कैन स्टार्ट नाउ आई थिंक।
मेहुल सर
शैल वी स्टार्ट?
या
ओके, विशिंग यू ऑल ए वेरी वार्म लाइव एंड वाइब्रेंट गुड मॉर्निंग। This is a five-day learning intervention pioneered by the TRIO, the dynamic TRIO, the three giant organizations who have come together, joined hands. It's a collaborative initiative taken by these three giant institutions, namely the Navsari Agricultural University in Navsari, Gujarat, Vasant Rao Naik Marathwada Krishi Vidyapeeth Parbhani, Maharashtra, and the Association of Agricultural Librarians and Documentalists of India, ALDI. These three institutions have come together to offer this five-day intervention, namely in national webinar series on a very relevant topic. The theme sounds as if we have brought something from the industrialist country like Japan. The theme is abbreviated as See, Saw, Know, sowing the seeds of knowledge to library and information science professionals. Yes, friends, we are delighted to have you all on this digital platform. We take note of the worthy presence of our chairman of the inaugural ceremony, the Honorable Vice Chancellor of Vasant Rao Naik Marathwada Krishi Vidyapeeth Parbhani Maharashtra, Dr. Ashok Dhawan sir. We also take note of the noteworthy presence of Dr. Urmila Ben Thakur, a living example of the rising power of women in all aspects of her life as we live in the era of women empowerment. She is the former professor and head of Library and Information Science Department from the world renowned Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel University, Vallabh Vidyanagar, Gujarat. We also take note of our guest of honor and our very own humble humanitarian, the action-oriented president of ALDI, Dr. K. Viran Jaleulu, sir. We also take note of the very dynamic duo, the Jodi number one of two dynamic organizing secretaries, the two university librarians, one from our worthy university, Navsari Agricultural University, Navsari, Gujarat, Dr. Kailas D. Kandel, and on the other hand, Dr. Santosh Kadam, sir, the university librarian of our collaborative institution, Vasant Rao Naik Marathwada Krishi Vidyapeeth, Parbhani, Maharashtra. We also wholeheartedly welcome all the 500 plus registered participants. Yes, I'm very delighted to let you know that we have received overwhelming response from all corners of our amazing nation. 512 official participants have registered, wherein 30% of these participants are from the vibrant state of Gujarat, 35% of the participants are from Maharashtra, and 35% of the rest participants are coming from all other states of our amazing nation. So we look forward to a very enriching five-day week coming ahead with us, wherein eminent resource persons handpicked by the organizing team would deliberate their thought process on topics of current concern, revolving around the central theme of sowing seeds of knowledge to the library and information science professionals. Without sparing much time, let me hand it over to the very dynamic organizing secretary of Vasant Rao Naik Marathwada Krishi Vidyapeeth Parbhani Maharashtra, Dr. Santosh Kadam, the university librarian of this worthy university, to extend a warm welcome in his choicest words. So I request Dr. Santosh Kadam to deliver the welcome address. Over to you, Kadam sir.
Good morning, one and all. At outset, I wholehearted welcome to all the dignitaries, resource persons, panelists, and participants from the different corners of the country to this national level development program on sowing the seeds of knowledge to the informational professionals. The galaxy of intellectuals, chairperson of this inauguration ceremony, Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. Ashok Dhawan sir, the chief guest Dr. Urmila A. Thakur ma'am, President ALDI, respected Dr. K. Viranjulu sir, and all the respected panelists and participants. As all of us very well know that information communication technology has a great impact on higher education system, and as library is considered as the heart of any university or higher education institutions, libraries are also having a great impact of information communication technology. And nowadays, information communication technology has become an integral part of each and every library and information center. Friends, today, due to advent of information technology, billions of pages are publishing every day worldwide. And due to this information flood, it's become very hectic to a librarian to provide pinpointed service to its users or its library users, because there is a great information flood, and with the help of information technology, librarian can provide pinpointed information to its users or to the library community. Also, nowadays, the role of librarian is not limited to the lending of books. The role of librarian nowadays is tremendously changed, and he is also considered as one of the important pillar in the higher education institution. And the role of librarian is enhanced in accreditation process, in ranking process, and due to this all, the library professional should be aware about the recent trends in information technology. The main object of behind the organization of this program is to make aware the library professionals about the emerging trends and technologies in the field of library and information science. So the program is designed that the participants will be able to acquire the knowledge about recent trends and technologies of the libraries. Since last 3 months, we all are suffering due to COVID-19, and this COVID-19 has its great impact on libraries also. So in this crucial period, libraries can provide their services to their users at their desktop or at their laptops or at their mobiles. So in this program, the discussions will be made on web-based library services, role of librarian in enhancing the image of institution in accreditation and in ranking process. Also, the training program will cover how to prepare video lectures so that we can help to the teachers to prepare their video tutorials, which will be helpful to the students to prepare their studies in this crucial period. Also, the program covers so many aspects of information technology, and I hope that the participants will be enlightened with the recent trends and techniques of library and information services. With this, I stop here. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Santosh Kadam, for not only extending a warm welcome to all the distinguished dignitaries who have joined on this digital platform and the panelists and the enthusiastic participants, but also acquainting all with the broad-sighted objectives of this 5-day learning intervention, 5-day national level webinar series initiated by NAU Navsari, Basant Rao Naik, Marathwada Krishi Vidyapeeth Parbhani, Maharashtra, and ALDI. I also take note of the fact that in this ICT era and given the uncertain times, there are multitude of roles being played by librarian information science professionals. And as with the state level, national level, and international rankings giving due importance to library and information science services also, every university of our amazing nation has started taking increasing care of library, its resources, and the associated staff led by the university librarians. And this has been, I'm very proud to state before all of you that this is the third of its kind national level webinar series initiated by the university library of our worthy university. This speaks in tons about the enthusiasm and the dynamism of the people who are associated with the university library of our worthy university. With this, we want to move ahead. And before I request one of the humble humanitarian to deliver his address and bless this kind occasion with his words of wisdom, let me quote two lines. You must have seen the famous ad campaign of Khaitan Fan way back. The tagline of Khaitan Fan used to be, Khaitan, sirf naam hi kaafi hai. So the same line fits in totality to our guest of honor, Dr. K. Viran Jaleulu sir. I am no one to introduce this towering personality, because Dr. K. Viran Jaleulu, the name is more than enough, just like Khaitan Fan. People who are associated with library science or agricultural libraries, they are well aware of his mammoth contribution for the upliftment of agricultural libraries and agricultural librarians. He is the action-oriented and visionary president of Association of Agricultural Librarians and Documentalists of India. Being a humble humanitarian, a very jolly natured person, he has been always on the forefront when it comes to uplifting the quality of services that is being provided to readers, scientists, or the researchers of universities. And he even takes due care of shaping the shapers, that is, uplifting the skill sets, sharpening the axe of the agricultural librarians and the librarians of other university setups. He also remains on the forefront for raising the issues which bothers the agricultural libraries and the librarians to different statutory bodies and their higher-ups as well. So with such a very action-oriented president at the helm of affairs, we are pretty sure that the agricultural libraries as well as other institutes which are involved in the development of agriculture in the nation would never remain on the back foot when it comes to providing quality services, even during such uncertain times. Let me hand over to Dr. K. Viranjaleulu with these four lines, which are typically in Gujarati, my mother tongue. Somebody has rightly quoted, "Parichay che mandir ma devo ne tamaro ne masjido ma tamne khuda odkhe che." Viranjaleulu sir, I am referring these four lines for your kind self. "Parichay che devo ne mandir ma tamaro ne masjido ma tamne khuda odkhe che. Nathi ahi chhanu tamaro vyaktitva koi thi, tamara satkaryo thi ahi tamne badha odkhe che." Meaning thereby, God knows you in the temple, sir, and Allah is aware of you in the mosque. Your multifaceted personality is not unknown to anybody over here. People know you by your good deeds for the agricultural librarian, sir. Over to you, sir, for your empowering address. Dr. K. Viranjaleulu, sir. Please, sir.
Thank you, sir, for your good words. I don't know whether I deserve it or not. Thank you for once again. And good morning, everybody. Today's chairman of the webinar, our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Ashok Dhawan, Vasantrao Naik, Marathwada Krushi Vidyapet, Parbhani. And today's our chief guest and keynote speaker, Dr. Urmila Bin A. Thakur, former professor and head, Department of Library Information Science, Sardar Patel University, Anand, Gujarat. Madam, now you can see that your product of student is doing lot of wonders in the nation now. And he has taken lot of lead to conduct the webinars in the COVID period also, that one. And you have produced a good called Library Science Scientist. He is useful for agriculture scientists producing and food security also in India also, so madam. And I like to invite resource persons and members of all the office bearers who are attending. Especially our General Secretary, Dr. Anpal, Vice President, Dr. S. Jadhav, and members, Dr. Negi Madam, Dr. Rohila, Dr. T. Srinivas Rao, and our Kailas Sandil sir, and others I invite you, and professional friends, all the members, and also the faculties, scientists, and students who are attending this one. And my special thanks and invitation to Dr. Mehul Thakur. Mehul Thakur starts any program under his anchorship, it will be successful, madam. And he is our, what you call, not only Navsari University, for the programs conducted by different universities in Navsari, they starts with Mehul Thakur. His hand is very good hand. Whenever we are going, the doctor also will see whether the boss of doctor and like that one. Mehul Thakur is also very, with good heartedly will start the program. And I'm also, that organizing secretaries who is taking a lot of pains to organize this one, consulting different experts and universities also. And Dr. Kailas D. Tandel and Dr. Santosh Kadam also. And first of all, I'm very thankful to the Honorable Vice Chancellors of the two universities, Dr. Ashok Dhawan sir and Dr. Chaudhary sir, for accepting to organize this program. Sir, all these organized so far two programs under the Aldi banner. One is individual only, others is with the help of cooperation with the collaboration of Navsari Agriculture University under the organizership of Dr. Tandel. And the Navsari Agriculture University organizing the third webinar in series. It is a faculty development, and each webinar they are taking it 5 years. This one, where they are including so many scientists, teachers, faculty members, and even library professionals also being here. This variety lay, they selected topic for this one national level faculty development program. So speak now. See, we are facing problem is China disease. The topic also they brought from Japan and other China also, like the topic is also like that one. Sowing seeds of knowledge to librarian information professionals. It is very important, that one. They have written librarian information professionals, but the information is available, and they covered the topics also very useful for the faculty also, students also, even research scientists also. They are very useful for them, this 5 days program. I would like to submit that one. The impact of webinars in learning and research is very much now. In COVID period, people are not able to move to other place. And the students, even they are not able to come to the colleges, and teachers and faculty is also not able to attend their regular duties. See, the webinars are creating some moral support to our scientists, teachers, and even our students also, that one. See, you are sitting in the home, last 3 months we are spending home, we will get some frustrations. And we'll get about this one. Our routine duties and other things are happening, that one. But these webinars are creating some moral support. And through the webinars, we are able to see our life is very busy life. But through in the COVID period, we are getting some leisure. And we can see that one, what is going on developing, what are the new technologies are coming, how we can serve the students, faculty, and this one. See, Madam, Urmila Madam, I would like to mention that one. The readers in the agriculture units are different compared to the general universities. We have the different types of readers are there. Our mandate of universities are education, research, and extension are there. For education, we have to prepare the quality manpower for India for agriculture development. And scientists, they conduct the research. You know that, madam, there is a land is static, but population is increasing. That how to serve our population to provide the food security and other things, the agriculture scientists work in that one. And the third one is, we will call as the extension system. In extension system, what happens, madam? What we have developed in the labs, it should be transferred and it should be reached to the farmers. Earlier, we will call as a lab to land. Now we can call to as a tap to land programs. We are implemented that one. See, now we can see that one. Now we can see that one. Our farmers are now very educated and very enthusiastic. That one. Earlier, farmers are in our education system, library science, we have studied that. Farmers are studying earlier farm magazines, radios, and now they are seeing that TVs and other programs. So now the farmers are referring mobile technology, they are using that one. They are sending the photographs if any disease is there in the crop also. That means nobody. First, nobody is given training to the farmers to use the mobile technology also. Now they are using mobile technology every day. They are getting the information regarding the agriculture, climate, weather, this one. How the knowledge is developed in the ICT environment, you know that one. That is agriculture university, especially under the leadership of ICR, able to develop so many things. See, without the development of varieties, deferred earlier, you know that. Paddy's period is like 7 months, 8 months, 9 months. It has become now only 150 days, 120 days we are able to produce crop. This is because of efforts of our agriculture scientists only. It is happening now, that one. And you know that one. And UGC also given some guidelines in COVID period, especially for teachers and faculty members who is in the home. They should prepare some question bank. They should prepare new projects, and they should prepare some e-courses, that one. And they should prepare some question banks and lesson plans, like they should prepare some MOOCs plans like that one. And they are also mentioned the resources, like, you know, agriculture, general universities, we have the consortium like ESO Sindhu is there, and E-Patashala is there, and we have the Swayam Prabha, and so many things are there, e-courses and other things are coming that one. Like that in agriculture also, we developed long back. And our agriculture universities and ICR is the credit of that one. In India, first we developed the institutional repository called doctoral dissertation, Kusi Prabha. It is the first in this one. And we have the, now I can say that one, our agriculture information is available, everything in our Krushi Kosh. We have developed like SERA, we have consulted for e-resources, 3,000 journals. And it is available all the scientists across the country. Even in not only in the university headquarters, they can access from the research stations, even what is called KVKs, everything. And we have the Krushi Kosh, where we have right now 150, 1,50,000 theses are available. and generals, rare books, and everything is available in this one. And we have the IDEAL platform, which is developed in the based upon Koha software. All agriculture universities and ICAR institutions, Union Catalog is available. When we are studying that one, people will talk about the Union Catalog. You can see virtually, you can experience that one, Union Catalog. You can know that one, resource sharing, which libraries are having that one. And recently we are added even college libraries under this one also. We can add that one. So that in single platform, we can access what are the resources available. And the advantages of this IDEAL is that one, we have the link with the open source books also. We are given the link that one. Even though your library is not purchased that book, it is available on the agriculture, other agriculture universities also. You can access that. And we have the e-courses also there. And generals, we have EPUBs are there, it is. And here we have more than 50 library agriculture generals are available, including archives also. So that in COVID period, the libraries are able to provide services to our users, like teachers, extension specialists, scientists, and students also, from their libraries sitting from home also they can have. And most of the libraries also implement a remote login system. Even IP-based access content also they can access from their desktops, their laptops, they can access that one there from even they can access them from their mobiles also they can access it. Some of the important topics covered under this program I will tell you, madam. Emerging technology in the field of library information science and measuring of impact of the scholarly publication, emerging tools and techniques, and Google Drive for creating database and small libraries also you can see applied, and boosting of research visibility, open source softwares for the e-content development, and smart skills for library professionals are required. Some of the contents what we have covered in this one I am telling you, madam. For example, I will tell you, there is a lot of emerging technologies we are implemented that one. See, our library professionals able to learn that one somewhat. We are now not in routine things like in library daily busy, and we are going that one issues books purchasing that one. But now we got some time to spend to learn so many new technologies like that one. We have, during your period, I think you are experienced like library automation, and we have open access resources, open access softwares, RFID technologies, consortiums, and e-learning and subject gateways, library 2.0, and institutional repository like distribution. But now upcoming technologies, we should learn that one. See, recently I have seen in the paper, some UK, they are sending books for students to drones, they are sending that one public libraries. They are not able to send through personally also. They are implemented recently and COVID period also. And we are discussing about some of the upcoming emerging technologies called digitization and institutional repositories, where the rare books and which are not available to content and institutional repository globally, you can access that one. And we have the electronic surveillance system for safeguard our contents, and the library consortiums, you are seeing a lot of things are coming that one in this one. Remote accesses, earlier we have only like gadget proxies. Now we are seeing that one, like MyLab, mobile technologies are coming that one, they can access from anywhere. And the RFID technologies, self-check-in, checkouts, that one we are seeing that one. And you can identify, now earlier what happens, it is taking a lot of time for stock verification. Now within hours, we can conduct the stock verification inventory within the support of the RFID technologies and IoT. Internet of things also we are implementing the libraries, and big data is analyzed in the libraries also. The blockchain technology we are using now, and makerspace, which are now popular in so many Western countries and American countries also. Library, they are providing for them skill development, like Skill India, like programs in the library also, they are providing that one. Apps, you know that one, nowadays apps have become very important, and most of the people are referring the apps for to get the information quickly and immediately, that also there. And library drones, which is a technology, earlier we are used in taking photos, and agriculture face side that one, but the libraries are now public libraries, especially they are using the drones, and artificial intelligence also we are using that one, and augmented realities also there. Earlier it is in the science only, now we are using the digital interface for the printed books, and the social networks are a good platform where we can share our knowledge also, we can do that one. And we have taken in the previous webinars, we have taken some of the topics which are very useful to our scientists and faculty members, like that one, plagiarism, and publishing quality research papers and integrating that one, what is integrating publishing research papers you are taking that one, where we are mentioned different things which are useful to our scientists and faculty also, that is an austerated general, what is austerated, and what is the UGC care list, what is that one, and what is the citation analysis of that one, how to get citation analysis, and H-index, and ARCAD IDC, recently you are seen in Eastern Institute rank framework, they are announced ranks. Most of the ranks which are came from the ranks they got because of that, the research productivity is playing important role in that one also. For any university, any institute getting good name and other things, research productivity plays very important for that one. Where we are given, like new things are coming, we are given to the exposure to our faculty, like we have seen that one, reference tools like Jotaro and Mendeley, like so many things, and the visibility of research products, how to get the visibility, how we can see that one, citation and H-index, like Web of Science, Scopus, India Citation Index, Research Gates, which are open source, we have Google Scholars, Academia, we are given exposure like so many things, which are useful not only our library professions, for faculty, students, and other things also. You know that, madam, earlier days, libraries means people are thinking that one issues of the books and letters. Now the libraries are becoming very dynamic, and there any technology comes first affected by the libraries. If the libraries are not able to develop themselves, they cannot serve the users. First, they have to develop their capacity program, and they have to serve their users. If libraries are able to know that one, where the information is available, Dr. S.R. Ranganathan told that fourth law of libraries, and save the time of the readers. You can save the lot of the time of the readers. For example, I will tell you, madam, earlier when we are doing the PhD, we used to spend days together, like 2 months, 3 months for collecting of review of literature. But now in the database, like we can go for that one. Within the seconds, we'll get that one, our review of literature and which subject we have, what are the things are available, that one. Whereas now I will tell you, sir, madam, Dr. Father of Nation, Gandhiji told that one, everything wait for agriculture will not wait for that one. If you are not able to provide right information in right time to the scientists and our faculty members, we cannot expect quality research of this one. And quality faculty and quality education system also. So the libraries, I would like to mention one or two things, madam. In our agriculture libraries are now full-fledged compared to the earlier, people are thinking that one, IIT's libraries are very advanced in India, like that one. But our agriculture libraries now very advanced because of that one. ICAR is providing library strengthening grants. For your information, madam, and honorable vice chancellor, for your information, sir, our libraries are now implemented all technologies like RFID technologies, remote login technologies, and digitization, and even open source, where we are all the libraries are participating in IDL for resource sharing also. And our consortium, we can say, which is effectively working, the consortium, where document delivery system is very effective compared to other consortiums of this one. And our consortium is in India still successfully number one consortium because of ICAR has taken a lot of gains. See, the government of India earlier and ICAR believes that if we are not able to provide quality information, we cannot expect quality research. We cannot expect quality graduates from agriculture universities. We cannot expect quality world-class librarians in this one. And you know that, madam, the India is country which is farm-based country, where agriculture is dominating that one also. And the population is increasing, but the land is not increasing, where agriculture scientists and faculty, our library people are playing very important role. That one. See, we are in a position that if any teacher, faculty ask any information, we are in a position to provide within the seconds because of our library, agriculture is affecting very effectively, and its impact is very well in the farming community, and even technology is also, they are implementing all the things. And I would like to thank once again Dr. Ashok Dhawan, sir, for your blessings for libraries. And Manavarada Agriculture University is one of the best university. Once upon a time, it is a world university, and they are providing their contribution in the national level also, very good, sir, that is. And it is a great opportunity for us to interacting with you, and it is our opportunity listening your message also from you, sir. And madam is that my appreciation for you, madam, for producing quality research products. Nowadays we are seeing that one. Education is different, administration and technology wise it means. But your student is all in one. He is having the administrative skills, technology skills, and even he is managing everything successfully. It is a great, I would like to congratulate on behalf of the association with that. He is organizing this webinar so seriously. This is the third. Now he is able to start a consultancy also. We'll call him Mr. Webinar also. And he is having a good knowledge of this one. The same time he is streaming with recording that one. He is trending the YouTube also that one. See, this is the skills we are required, whereas that one, every people are, they can provide the services also, they can have the technical knowledge. Earlier, 20-25 years back, we are depending more on computer science people, madam. But our own library people are doing software, all the things are, we are doing because of the blessings of our senior teachers only we are able to do, madam. And once again, thank you to the organizers for giving this opportunity. And thank you, and I wish all the best once again. The organizing secretaries, Santosh Kadam, Dr. Santosh Kadam, Dr. Kailas Tandel sir also for their initiatives for sharing the knowledge where you can spend our time. See, without this, what happens? You are sitting in the home, ideally spending that. Sometimes we may get the frustration. Sometimes we'll get the different opinions. We'll get that one. But it gives it to overcome all these frustrations and problems with this one, and to increase our improvement, our knowledge also, it is very useful. Thank you once again, everybody. Thank you, sir. Over to
thank you so much, sir. What an enlightening, energizing, and empowering address from your side. I would love to quote two lines. Kaun kehta hai aasma mein suraag nahi ho sakta? Kaun kehta hai aasma mein suraag nahi ho sakta? Ek patthar to tabiyat se uchhalo yaaro. Meaning thereby, who says we cannot make a hole in the sky? If you are determined to throw a stone with passion, when you have such a caring, concerned, and competent leader as the president of ALDI, all agricultural librarians would definitely be serving as warriors even during such uncertain times. They are tech-savvy generation. They are truly emerging as information warriors and knowledge resource managers in these uncertain times, and giving even remote access of e-resources to millions of students, researchers, and teachers, and relieving them from the unnecessary anxiety that they might be facing during such uncertain times. He rightly appreciated the committed approach and the passionate outlook of our university librarian, Dr. Kailas Tandel, who has actually taken the lead to bring all the agricultural librarians from their comfort zone and initiated to organize such a national level webinar series. And ALDI supported our efforts with hand in hand, and all their esteemed office bearers, leading from the front, the visionary president, the vice president, Dr. U.S. Jadhav sir, the dynamic secretary, Kandpal sir, who is also giving us the technical support, and all other leading office bearers, Mrs. Yashoda Negi ma'am, and all others are really supportive of this entire initiative. And we even take note, even on digital platforms, we can feel the positive vibe of the ever smiling our chairman of the inaugural ceremony, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Ashok Dhawan sir. Now I move ahead in this inaugural ceremony, and before I request our chief guest and the keynote speaker of the day, I would love to quote two lines from our scriptures. Yatra Naryasyutu Pujyante Ramante Tatra Devata. मतलब है कि जहां नारी शक्ति का पूजन होता है वहां देवता भी निवास करते हैं. Where women are respected, over there even God resides. And here in the vibrant state of Gujarat, just near to the milk capital of India, we have a high-tech education hub called Vallabh Vidya Nagar, having the university, a leading state university of our state, with the name of the Iron Man of India, Sardar Patel University. Our chief guest and the keynote speaker happened to be the former professional head of Librarian Information Science, and she is a leading example of rising power of women in all aspects of life. Today, women are not the second citizen of a developing nation like us. If man is the head of the family, then women is the neck on which the head rests. With these positive vibes, I hand over the introduction part to Dr. Kailash Tandel, sir, who will brief us about our chief guest, towering personality, Dr. Urmila Ben Thakur. I request Dr. Kailash Tandel to do the honor to introduce this personality to all of us. Over to you, Tandel, sir.
Thank you, Mehul, sir. Respected Vice Chancellor of Vasant Rao Marathawada University. Respected our President Dr. K. Viranjalu, sir, and respected my Madam Dr. Urmila Ben Thakur. It is a great honor for me to give an introduction of who am I going to give an introduction today. Such is a great sage among us, Dr. Urmila Ben Thakur. Her education qualification include a Master of Arts in Gujarati and Sanskrit, Master of Library Science, Master of Philosophy, and PhD in the Library Information Science. She has done 10 to 12 major projects. Who is a reputed University of Gujarat, SP University, Vallabh Vidyanagar Anand, retired professors and head. She also emerits a professor, which was appointed by UGC of India. Madam is a very knowledgeable person, and he has a lot of research work experience in the information communication and current awareness service, Master of Philosophy, computerization of university library in Gujarat is her PhD topics. She has completed, she has done 10 to 12 major projects, which is given by the UGC. And he has also experience of the resource guidance, PhD guide in the three university, Sardar Patel Vallabh University, Hemachandra North Gujarat University, Patna, and Gujarat Vidyapeeth, Ahmedabad. Guiding member, PhD scholar, 10 scholars are awarded, including myself, and one scholar is pursuing. Guided more than 45 Master of Philosophy dissertations, guided more than 300 Master of Library Information Science dissertations. Ma'am has also published 6 books, that is the Information Analysis, Rural Community Information, Library Network in India, Indexing and Process. It is a very knowledgeable books, and all our PhD scholars and Master of Library Science students are using these books, and this is a very important books for the library and information professionals. Madam is also more than 5 and 6 book edited, Library and Information Science 21st Century, Knowledge Management Digital Era. And Madam is also published the book in the literature subject. That is the 5th Gujarati poet. It is a very popular book in the Gujarat. Madam also edited the literature book. There is a 6 books are Madam edited. So Madam has a lot of experience in the library information science, and also experience in the literature also. Madam is Madam has a membership of the UGC expert committee, state level eligibility test examinations, member in various university committees, Indian Association of Teachers, Indian Library Association, Adinet, Granthalaya Seva Sangh, Gujarat Sahitya Parishad. She has also held the honorary position of the Emirate professors, which is I previously told you, which is the appointed by the UGC. So I am very honored to introduce to my madam, and I am also proud to, I am the one of the students of the PhD, one of the PhD students, which is done the PhD under guidance of my Dr. Urmila Ben Thakur. So we lot of proud to introduce to our Dr. Urmila Ben Thakur. Behul sir.
Oh, what a coincidence we are having right now on the digital platform. Proud teacher and an accomplished product of that proud teacher. Both of them are with us. One is managing the webinar as the organizing secretary, and the other, the manufacturing division of such a proud product, Dr. Urmila Ben Thakur, the former professor and head of library and information science, as the chief guest of our inaugural ceremony. I request Honorable Ma'am to deliver the keynote address. Over to you, Ma'am, please.
Good morning, everybody. First of all, congratulations to Vice Chancellor of Agriculture University, Vice Chancellor of Vasantrao Vidyapeeth, Krushi Vidyapeeth, Marathawada, and Association of Agriculture Librarians for organizing this type of national level of faculty development program. And thank you very much for inviting me as a chief guest. Thank you. Now, I will put my presentation. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. We are watching.
Yes. I like your subject very much. Sowing seeds of knowledge is a very good process, and society will get lots of crops of knowledge through library and information allies professionals. And the you have framed or a coin a very good phrase, the see, so see, know. It's a very good phrase coined by you all. And the faculty development program for librarian is very important for the development of librarian's career and library staff itself. Introduce first, we have to remember our father of library information science, Dr. S.R. Ranganathan, who had a sixth sense. In 1931, he wrote the Five Laws of Library Science, and he gave five laws. We know. And all the five laws are we have to consider in the recent context or in the context of new environment, we have to consider it. The fifth law is the library is growing organization. Dr. Ranganathan has given this is the fifth law. It is also true today. We have, because today our library is a global library. Library is a global, each library is a global library. It's growing. Day to day, our library is growing with the digital data, digital libraries and global libraries, and we are doing cooperative work with each other. And that means our library is a growing organization. Tremendous changes and growth of all fields and academic research has impact on our library. This faculty development program. I congratulate to put a faculty development program for the library, for the librarian. What is faculty development program and why faculty development program and what type of faculty development program should be in our field? That I have discussed in the this lecture. The faculty development, the American Association of Higher Education has given definition of faculty development. Faculty development is the theory practice of facilitating improved faculty performance in a variety of domains, include institutional, intellectual, personal, social, and pedagogical. And program for librarian, faculty development program for librarian means it is also a theory of practice of facilitating to improve librarian's performance to fulfill expectation of users of knowledge-based society and to apply new tools, new techniques in the libraries to provide qualitative services to the users. Why there is a need of faculty development programs? Because of rapid development in the technology domain have a tremendous influence on library work, emerging landscape of technologies has created ample opportunities for librarians to adopt offer better and effective services as demanded by the users. To get expertise in searching, accessing, analyzing, organizing, presenting, and preserving information found in various formats. Today, number of websites, total global, we can see the number of websites are giving lots of database and lots of information, huge information is available on website. It is very difficult to search the information. It needs expertise to search the information. If you search, then you have to access. Information may be free, you may have to subscribe it, and when you collect, access the information, then for users, for your users, you have to analyze the organized information. You have to analyze the information. Means you have to content analysis, content management. After analysis, you have to do organize the information and presenting for your users. Types of users are different. As per users' need, you have to present your information and preserving information. All the information we have to preserve for future users, future needs. That's why each and every librarian and library staff should have experience, training. They should have some skill, competency for it. And to manage digital data and various new modes of information There are various modes of information generation, and number of we have to library has to manage digital data which is available in different format. For that, there is need of development program day to day to provide dynamic and quality user-centered service. Your users are different. In past, users were used to come library, take book and go out. But now users are end users. They are remote users and their needs are different. And we have to provide dynamic services to those users who needs different types of quality services. And to provide high quality scholarly information resources, we have to be ready. We should have some training or we should have some exercise. We have to do how to do. Each and every librarians are able to do, but day to day new techniques are coming, new tools are coming. We have to take training. That's why faculty development program should be necessary. The better partner in helping to work in present situation, COVID-19. Because librarians have to work as a warrior and they have to provide all the information for COVID-19. There are number of sites and number of association institutions, they are provide e-resources for COVID-19. Library Connect at elsewhere.com is also provided free information for COVID-19. They collect all the information regarding COVID for the different research articles regarding health, immunity, and the vaccine, etc. And they provide free elsewhere, Emerald, all free, provide free articles for COVID-19. But we should know it is available, where available, how to take it from there, how to provide our users on the spot. It is free and free for your users also. Otherwise, they are provider of information. They are not giving nothing in free. But COVID information, they are providing free for librarians. There are a number of sites. To be successful and effective librarian in knowledge-based society, there is need of often the faculty development program for librarian. There are various technology in our field, as affected in our library also. Technology and libraries. Most commonly developed technology, which is used in the library. We are using in the library. Library management software, we know Koha. You all know Koha, Evergreen, NewGenLib. How to download, how to use it, information regarding the software, each and everyone does not know, but in the program they can get a practical experience in the faculty development program, library management software, then digital repository software. Types of software are available. You librarians, you all know, and your agricultural librarians are very advanced. You know each and everything, but your staff, they should know. Your users should know. The library repository, digital library software, vSpace, between GSDA, Fedora, etc. Then metadata harvester, RSS, and atomic feeds, Z3950. All this is available, but how to use it? For our users, how to find out information, how to manage our information, how to provide information. For that, we should have practical training. And for practical training, there should be the faculty development program for librarians. There are federated search engine, consortia-based softwares, then Web 3.0. Number of websites are there, and number of unorganized informations are there. From there, librarian has to find out relevant information as per their users' need. How to find out, how to manage, how to preserve, how to present, how to provide to technology. That's why it needs training. Same library 3.0, then reference management software. Researchers are using number of references, but how to manage their reference? Librarians are also using number of references, but how to manage their references? There are number of reference management software, Zotero, Mendeley. Each librarian or a researcher has to know regarding Zotero, Mendeley, and other reference management software are also there. They have to know how to use this reference management software and how to manage our references which we have used in our research. And librarians manage for their users. Then open source softwares. There are a number of open source software are there. Librarians should know each and everything regarding them. Then it is a technology and library. Now, information technology, information environment, we can say information landscape is totally changed. And everything is available in the sky, cloud computing, cloud technology is there. And how to find out? We should know our information environment. The technological advancement and internet has changed the whole scenario of information environment in this digital world or in the knowledge-based society. Tremendous growth in volume and varieties of sources. There are types of sources available. Number of sources available, which is authentic, which is good one, which is easily available, which is free, which is subscribed documents, we do not know. With the training of this, we can find out all the things. Librarian can find out the particular reference. Various type of database available online, free as well as the subscription. Yes, you know, full-text salary databases are available, metadata is available, abstract and index databases are available. List of academic databases are available, which are free, which are with subscription, it is also available. This knowledge should be with us. And institutional repository, open access projects are also available, and institutional repository, number of institutional repositories are working today. And how to find out the repository which is relevant with our subject, that we have to learn from this program. And the main thing is the open educational resources. There are number of open educational resources are available, and how to use. Our users do not know. Our researchers do not know how to find out all these things, how to join with this, how to get the information. That the role of librarian is as an instructor. He has to teach them how to use our open educational resources. Then information seeking behavior. The main thing is information seeking. Our users are different. That information seeking behavior is also different. We have to understand our users, what they need, how to, they need. But even though they are always online, they are accessing their information online. and prepare their academic assignment, their research. We can see all the students of the school students, college students, teachers, researchers, all are using network and online, where they are going each and every site and find out the information. This is their behavior. Information seeking behavior. This seek the information, search the information, but users do not know which is the authentic information, which is the current information, accurate information, and completeness of information. They do not know which I have said the information, is it complete or a completeness is there? No, they do not know. It's the role of librarian. Librarian has to play a number of new roles. There was need of this faculty development program for librarians. Then currently, users are not aware of authentic sources. There are a number of sources are available, but is the source, the particular source is authentic source? No, they do not know. Not all, but most of users do not know. Information search tools, they do not know the search tools, number of search tools and search techniques are available. How to search our independent information? How to search exponential information expeditiously? For that, there are a number of techniques, but our users do not know. Our librarian has to know each and everything and help our users. Then the question of copyright. While it is a very serious question of copyright and plagiarism and information ethics and fair use. Our students for the project, going to any website, they search the information, find out it and note it. But they do not know how to write. When you take the information, how much information they can take from the particular sources, they have to mention the references, how to put the references, and plagiarism. Number of things are open and they can take, but there is also, they have to take care of plagiarism. There is a serious question. And then information ethics. Then how to prepare FDP program for librarians, particularly for librarians. Need assessment to prepare relevant program. Faculty development program, there are a number of program and guideline has given by UGC, IICT, IFLA has given guideline for FDP program. But particularly for librarians, we have to do a need assessment to prepare relevant program. Which type of need is there for our librarians? Need assessment, we have to do survey of the even site also. What is available online, global level, and the basis of outcome of this design, our outcome to design, develop, and implement a variety of programs to meet diverse needs of our users. On the basis of technological information landscape, all the aspect, when we prepared our course content for every, that we have to, what to cover, then we have to cover, we have to go through technological landscape as well as information landscape, and all the aspect we have to check and we have to cover in our course content for our librarians, FDP. Now, how to prepare FDP for librarians? Sorry. Next, I have given some references for COVID. COVID-19, e-resources for librarians. It is available, e-resources for librarians. You might be knowing the e-resources for librarian. And it is, I have given link also. You will go there, you will get a number of references regarding your COVID-19. And so many institutions, there are a number of institutions, publishers provide free access of e-resources for COVID-19, such as APA, American Psychological Association provides information regarding the COVID-19, regarding the virus, the virus health, then immunity, and research on vaccine and medicine, all the type of information they have collected from other sources and they provide. Then Cambridge University Press, CyPress, CDC, Center for Disease Control and Prevention, Project News, Springer Nature, then Taylor and Francis also provide the free resource, the free information for your users. The BMJ, Willy Online Library, COVID-19, they provide all information available from different places. They collect and provide for librarian for their users. They provide free. It is also important. My information providers, publishers never give the free information, but this information they provide to the librarian for their users. And in this time of global uncertainty, we hope that you or your family, your personal and professional community stay healthy and connected. Stay connected. Thank you very much.
Neville, sir.
Thank you so much for such an elaborative discussion presented by Dr. Urmila Bain, our chief guest in the keynote address. Moving ahead, now we have with us our chairman of the inaugural ceremony and the honorable vice chancellor of Vasantrao Naik Marathwada Krishi Vidyapeeth Parbhani, Maharashtra. Before I hand it over to him for delivering the chairman's address, let me brief this August gathering about. I request all other participants to keep their microphone on mute. Before I hand over for the chairman's address to our chairman of the inaugural ceremony, let me brief this August gathering about such exemplary, noteworthy figure that we have with us on this digital platform as the chairman of the inaugural ceremony. He is a veteran academician and administrator with core focus, keen interest and proven expertise in the domain of agriculture. He graduated way back in 1978 from the then Marathwada Agricultural University. Then he post-graduated and even earned his doctorate degree from the world-renowned IARI, New Delhi. In his exemplary service, over 35 years of rich experience, he has served in various capacities in the agriculture university system, right from assistant professor to associate professor to professor to associate dean and principal to director of extension education to dean of instruction to the honorable vice chancellor. At present, he is providing the much needed direction to the Vasantrao Naik Marathwada Krishi Vidyapeeth Parbhani, Maharashtra in the capacity of Honorable Vice Chancellor since 1st June 2018. Not only this, if we talk about his exemplary and benchmark accomplishments, he has served as the FAO Fellow at the Oregon State University, Corvallis, USA, and at the University of California, Davis, during December 1995 to March 1996. He has been on the Governing Council as the member of Association of Indian Universities, New Delhi. He has also been a proud recipient of state level Sri Ankush Rao Tope Lifetime Achievement Award in 2019. Being a voracious researcher, he has 70 plus publications in journals of repute at the national and international level. Not only this, if we talk about the extension literature, he has 100 plus publications to his credit. He has delivered 50 plus radio and TV talks for the farming and scientific community, and he has 50 plus scientific reports, bulletins, book chapters, and edited monograph to his credit. He has guided 30 plus MSc and PhD students. So a very eminent personality, a thorough academician, an efficient administrator, and above all, a caring and concerned visionary leader of Vasantrao Naik Marathwada Krishi Vidyapeeth Parbhani, Maharashtra, the co-host of these national webinar series, is with us as the chairman of the inaugural ceremony. Sir, we are highly delighted to have you as the chairman of the inaugural ceremony. We are, our morale and motivation have reached to another level with your exemplary presence. We look forward to your inspiring address to all these enthusiastic participants, delegates, and dignitaries. Please, sir, over to you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Mehulji, for your nice words about me. But sometimes, you know, it becomes very difficult or rather embarrassing when a person is projected larger than the life image. But anyway, I take it with humility, the kind of words which you have used for me. Anyway, the chief guest of this today's function, Madam Urmila Ben Thakar, the president of the Association of Agricultural Librarians and Documentalists of India, Dr. Viren Jainalu, my colleagues, Dr. Santosh Kadam, and of course the librarian from Navsari Agricultural University, Dr. Kailas Tandail, then Mr. Kalyanji Tekale, for own colleagues, and my own student during his agricultural graduate days. Of course, the colleagues, other colleagues from my university. At the outset, I compliment the organizers of this webinar, the joint organizers from both the universities, Navsari Agricultural University and Navsari Gujarat, and Vasantrao Naik Marathwada Krishi Vidyapeeth, as well as the ALDI. I also appreciate the kind of theme they have suggested for this webinar, the sowing seeds of knowledge. It's a very catchy phrase they have coined, because knowledge is not a stable thing. It's always a very dynamic mechanism. And virtually there is an explosion of knowledge, and it becomes rather difficult to handle and channelize the knowledge, and the librarians have to play a very important role in channelizing this knowledge and making available to the scientific community. So it is in this context, the webinar of this kind holds a great promise. Friends, after listening to Madam Urmila Ben's very scholarly presentation, because she had a very long innings in the field of library sciences. To be very frank with you, I'm not an expert in the library science, but perhaps I'm the biggest beneficiary of the library science, being a student of agriculture. And today also, when I enter into my university library, you can confirm with Santosh, I never entered my library as a vice chancellor. Today also, I entered the library as a student of agriculture, being a biggest beneficiary of agriculture. Because the library holds a very important position in the overall academic environment. You know, while introducing me, Mehulji has said that I have done my postgraduate studies, MSc and PhD, both in IRI. And IRI is a very world-famous institution. But still, the identity of the institution is always projected by that library tower. You must have seen it in the picture with a clock tower and all these things. So that becomes an identification mark. And library holds a great promise and the very heart of the academic institutions. He may be a casual visitor of the institution, or he may be a very organized visitor, maybe for the assessment and accreditation of that concerned academic institution. Without visiting library, the process of accreditation and assessment cannot be completed. Because in Marathi, there is one saying, the Sita Varun Bhataji Pariksha. You know, you didn't have to test the entire rice in the rice cooker. Just pick up a grain, and the grain itself gives an idea about the quality of the cooked rice. Similarly, the library holds that kind of promise. If a person visits the library and see the kind of services extended to the academic world through this library building or library institution, he can make out the impression about the quality of the institution to which he is visiting. That's the kind of a promise the library holds. And over the years, as they have coined the term sowing seeds of knowledge, as I said in the beginning, that knowledge has been exploding with every passing day. What we consider as today's knowledge, tomorrow it becomes an obsolete. And handling and channelizing this knowledge for the benefit of the academic world, it becomes a Herculean task for the librarians. Unless or until they are exposed, unless or until they are given an appropriate training, unless or until they are given appropriate mindset to cope up with the library services, because it is simply not the place where the books are kept and they are exchanged between the reader and the giver. But at the same time, the kind of information which a library is supposed to give it, it's a tremendous. And over the years, a lot of ICT tools have been come into existence to handle this information. And it is in this context, a library has to make himself or herself aware about how to make use of these ICT tools in the better service of the scientific community. And it is in this context, a webinar of this kind holds a great promise. I'm very happy to see the list of experts. They are drawn from the different institutions, and they bring with them a very rich and a very long experience in the field of library sciences. At the same time, as Mehulji has given an analysis, overall analysis of the participant, there is a tremendous response from overall country. Almost one-third divisions are one-third from Gujarat state, one-third from the Maharashtra state, and the rest one-third, they cover the entire India. So this is the kind of, this particular virtual platform has a tremendous power to gather both resource persons and the trainees together. Although because of the COVID crisis, we have been physically isolated from each other, sitting in respective department, respective institutions. But intellectually, we are together with each other. And it is in this context, we are using a full benefit of this virtual platform to deliver the kind of information, kind of training to the trainees. I'm sure in the next 4 or 5 days, our trainees will be immensely benefited out of the rich and knowledgeable discourses being offered to them by the different experts belonging to different institutions. It is in this context, once again, I give them a best compliments for organizing this kind of webinar and wish them a great success. Thank you very much. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you so much, sir. After a long, long time, such a crystal clear thought process with a very sharp, very straightforward remark on the underlying agendas, on the need of the hour for the library science professionals. Truly inspiring and awesome remarks from the chairman of the inaugural ceremony, the Honorable Vice Chancellor of Vasantrao Naik Marathwada Krishi Vidyapeeth Parbhani Maharashtra, Dr. Ashok Dhawan sir. With this, we are moving towards wrapping up the inaugural ceremony to propose the formal vote of thanks and express sense of gratitude. I request the organizing secretary from NAU Navsari, Dr. Kailas D. Tandil, the university librarian, to propose the formal vote of thanks. Over to you, Kailas.
Thank you, Mehul sir. Good afternoon to one and all. Honorable Vice Chancellor of Vasantrao Naik Marathwada Krishi Vidyapeeth Parbhani and today's function chairman Dr. Ashok Dhawan sir, respected Dr. Urmila Ben Thakur, former professor, SP University, Vallabh Vidyanagar, Gujarat, and chief guest of today's functions, respected Dr. K. Viranjalu sir, president of the ALDI and guest of honor of the today's functions, respected dignitaries, senior professors, and dear participants. And our panelists, Dr. C.K. Patel, Dr. K.N. Kanpal, Dr. U.S. Jadhav sir, Dr. Kalyan sir, Mr. Rakesh sir, Harish Tripathi sir, Santosh Kadam sir, Madam Vandana Ben Jadhav madam, Mr. Rohila sir, and dearest participants. It is my proud to privilege to propose the word of thanks and behalf of Navsari Agriculture University and Vasant Rao Nayak Krishi Vidyalay Vidyapeeth and ALDI. Today we are assembled here to learn the operation of the fast information extraction and swift automations through digitizations in agricultural libraries. At this juncture, Association of Agriculture Librarians and Documentalists of India, that is ALDI, Navsari Agriculture University, Navsari, and Vasant Rao Nayak Marathawada Krishi Vidyapeeth jointly organized the national level faculty development program, sowing seed of knowledge to library and information professionals, requirements of library users. Let me start with the Almighty God who sovereign choice the blessing on me and my team to empower us to think of such a premium category events. We are heartily thankful to Vice Chancellor of Vasant Rao Nayak Marathawada Krishi Vidyapeeth for the gracing our functions and for the sparing his valuable time in spite of his busy and hectic schedules. Sir has shown his keen interest in these functions as outcome of the national level faculty development program will be beneficial to agriculture and traditional university library and information professionals. I acknowledge the presence of former professors and head of SP University, Vallabh Vidyanagar, Gujarat, Dr. Urmila Ben Thakur Madam, on these occasions. Madam is always encouraged us to organize such constructive events and providing his valuable inputs towards successful exhibitions. Madam, we are honored by your presence in the functions and on behalf of all of us, I express my sincere gratitude to you. We are also grateful to Dr. K. Viranjalu sir to jointly provided opportunity to host this national level faculty development program on Zoom platform. Sir, we are aware that you are busy in the research and project activities, but you have accepted our invitations and spent valuable time with us. We are fortunate enough to be benefited from your knowledge in this national level faculty development program. We also express my thanks to our panelists necessary backbone support all the time. Ladies and gentlemen, the wheels of these events initiated rolling only a week ago. It required meticulous planning from all angles. I am thankful to all university authorities of Navsari Agriculture University and Vasant Rao Marathawada University Krishi Vidyapeeth and all committees members who have contributed a lot of for the successful educations of this national level faculty development program. We are fortunate enough to be backed by a team, a highly motivated and dedicated staff member of the board library, that is Navsari Agriculture University and Vasant Rao Marathawada Krishi Vidyapeeth. Mr. Dimbar, Dr. Jadhav Madam, my dearest friend, also organized secretary, Dr. Santosh Kadam, Dr. Kalyan, and others. I would like to thank for their extraordinary support in proofreading proofreading of the brochure and etc. I am very much thankful to all the participants, library professionals, and participants who have come from across India for actively participating in the national level faculty development program. I also thank our HRD man, Dr. Mehul Ji Thakkar, for his powerful and impressive anchoring and giving a sparking start of the five days national level faculty development program. Last but not least, I kindly extend my sincere thanks to Dr. Madhav Pandey. He wants to join us but he has other important tasks, so he do not able to join us. I am profusely thanks on all who stood by me and my entire team, as direct and indirect, for the grand success of the national level faculty development program by their continued willing support. Thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Kailas sir, for formally thanking.
With the permission of Madam Thakkar sir, I would like to thank the today's chief guest, madam, and our honorable vice chancellor of Marathwada Agriculture University for their concern and blessing this occasion also. Madam, we are very thankful to madam. You are spending valuable time here and blessing us all. People like our library professionals, youngsters are required seniors blessings, madam, to learn more things and to implement in the libraries, madam. Thank you for all the team for their support on behalf of the ALDI and for successfully conducting. This is a fourth webinar with the collaboration of Dr. Tandale and our ALDI members are conducting, madam. Thank you that one. Already our resource person is waiting. Suresh Jengi sir is a very busy person. And we are very happy that, sir, you are seeing here Dr. Suresh Jengi. Sir is my close friend and like my brother. And we are great opportunity, sir, to learn from you so many things also, sir. Now I request our Mel Thakkar, sir, for the other
okay. proceedings. Thank you so much, sir, for taking utmost care of thanking all the distinguished people who have shared their thought process with these August gathering during the inaugural ceremony. Now, as you rightly mentioned, that the resource person is already there. The pilot is ready. The flight is ready to take off. And I request Kailas Tandale, sir, to take over for the proceedings. All passengers have tightened their seat belts also. We would be going to the amazing flight which will take us to the new frontier of knowledge and wisdom. Our resource person, the pilot, is taking utmost care. I hand it over to Kailas Tandale, sir, for the proceedings. I am signing off. Thanking you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Mabel, sir. Now I would like to request Deggy, madam, to introduce our vibrant expert guest speaker, Dr. Suresh Jengi, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Respected
madam, you can proceed, madam. You can.
Okay. Respected vibrant president, Dr. K. Veeranjulu, sir, General Secretary, Dr. K. Kanwal, and all the office bearers of the ALDI and the all the participants. It's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Suresh Jengi. Now I am going to introduce her biodata. Dr. Suresh Jengi, University Librarian, working in Virtual Library Resource Center, Digital Library, Gulbarga University in Karnataka. He was awarded gold medals in B-Libacy and M-Libacy with the qualification of National Eligibility Test, NET. He obtained PhD degree in 2004. He is the coordinator of the Implement Center for eShodh Sindhu and Shodh Ganga project. He has completed research project on development of e-content on traditional knowledge and folk wisdom of Hyderabad in 2012. He is the coordinator for digital knowledge project in 2015 to 2016. He completed project on open air green library and the RFID technology in 2019 to 2020. He has received two prestigious international fellowships. The one is the IFLA ALP fellowship in 2007 and second is Commonwealth Professional Fellowship in 2013. He is a president of many associations. He is the first president or president Karnataka University Library Association and he is the council member of Indian Library Association, New Delhi. And third one is Karnataka government has nominated him as a member of the state level book selection committee in the state of Karnataka. He is a very learned person. I'm sure his lecture will be definitely help all of us. Thank you, sir.
Okay, very good afternoon to all of you.
Sir, thank you, Nagi madam, and I would like to request. I would like to request Dr. Suresh Jhange sir, please deliver the lectures. His topic is a smart skill, role of librarians and catalyst for the building image of the institute. So I hand over to Dr. Jhange sir.
Very good afternoon to all of you. Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. Ashok Ashokji, President of ALDI, and my very good friend Dr. Aviranjaliji. Keynote speaker Dr. Urmila Ben Thakurji, dynamic librarian Dr. Santosh Kadam, and all the delegates and participants and my dear friends. Today I have been entrusted with the responsibility to deliver a talk on smart skills, means what would be the role of a librarian, so that the image of not only as an individual will be enhanced, but more importantly, how we play important role as a catalyst in order to build the image of an institution, that matters a lot. So my outline of presentation would be on covering the skills. See, today everyone is talking about skills, skill development, but there is a lot of difference between academic skill and employability skills. See, theory is different and practice is different. These two things we need to understand. And what is the position of skill development in India with respect to library and information science, that we will see. So without these smart skills, we don't think we can exist or we can continue to serve in a better way in the academic libraries. And for that, what type of different types of skills are required for a librarian, let us see the in detail about different types of skills. Okay, then I will concentrate upon the awards and fellowship that one can go ahead for a librarian, and more importantly, how to calculate the API score, academic performance indicator. So that's also a skill. So these are some of the unique areas where there is a more important that I will be touching upon, rather than overlapping the same presentation. Okay. So it was a dream of our late Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam to build the knowledge society, and this cannot be achieved without possessing the skills that is required to map the current employability environment of a library system. And one of the best quote, you know, especially for agricultural librarians and agricultural scientists, which I could note down from your own website, is that the farmers are the soul of our planet. And if at all the farmers are the soul of our planet, then definitely the agricultural scientists are the super soul of the planet. And for that, to support academic and research pursuit of agricultural scientists, and it is we, the librarian, who have to play a significant role. For that, see, mere acquiring the academic qualification or academic skills is not enough. We need to have be more of an innovative in nature. And today, see, we are all living in this fascinating time of a change and a promise, wherein nothing is constant, everything is changing, life is full of uncertainty. We do not know what is going to happen in the next moment of our life, especially this COVID-19 or a coronavirus or a China virus. So it has really created a pandemic among all of us, you know, and it is affecting almost all aspects of our life. See, I wish to tell you here, ye jindagi haseen hai, isse pyar karo, abhi hai raat, to subah ki intezaar karo, wo pal bhi aayega, jiski khwahish hai humko, bhagwan par rakho bharosa, waqt par aitbaar karo. So let us be very positive, let us pray the Almighty, maybe Sri Ram, Rahim, and Jesus, to get rid of this coronavirus from the entire world. And hopefully this we will be getting out very soon. And my dear academician and library friends, see, what is more important today is how we have to exhibit our skills during this COVID-19, during this coronavirus is please very important. You see, prior to corona, so we rendered lot of services, lot of innovation. That's fine. But today, especially in this situation, what would be our role? How we have to really exhibit our skills? Organizing a webinar for a faculty development or making ourselves visible in the webinar, that's fine. Okay, that's one part of life. But how we can really help our own students? How we can really help our own teaching faculty? Okay, so there lies our importance. For that, you know, see, the librarians have to play an important role in the academic life of our students, our research scholars, and teaching faculty. If you just have a look at what sort of a thing as a librarian can exhibit his skill or her skill in this COVID-19. You see, it is not that if you are only supporting our students and faculty with just a syllabus-oriented learning course material. Of course, there are plenty of learning course materials and electronic resources under FIRA Consortia is available that you as a librarian needs to disseminate to the students and the faculty by using a WhatsApp group, by using a Facebook, by using a email, by forming your own group so that they need to be updated with all sorts of e-resources that are available in your library. Not only that, there are plenty of electronic resources which are also available free that needs to be passed on to the students and the faculty. And this sort of an academic oriented e-resources is fine, but you also look upon the competitive examination material which are required for our students. Okay, so there are plenty of electronic resources which are concerned for competitive preparation. You see, it is not only a syllabus oriented, because our students and faculty will get bored, you know, bored because of only the same type of material that you are sending. Think of a material which really gives some sort of enthusiasm. So try to send any competitive examination material which is required for our students and faculty. And not only that, so because we also need to send some of the entertained information also. Entertained information in the sense like maybe a personal fitness, how to keep our students and the teaching faculty fit in this time of a COVID. See, there are a lot of videos, there are a lot of materials are available which you need to orient to your students and faculty. There may be any yoga YouTube may be there. There may be a Surya Namaskara. How will the Surya Namaskara have to be done? You see, these sort of a material which we need to send to our students and faculty. Don't confine a librarianship to only to the library resources. Okay, that's fine. But beyond that, we need to think. Okay, and you also help and ask your students not to waste the time. There are a lot of webinars are being conducted. There are a lot of online programs like Swayam. You see, they have a plenty of time. Time bahut hai unka paas. If you tell them to join webinar and just join for any of the certification courses from Swayam, maybe 15 days or 1 month. So this is a time they can really fetch the good knowledge and make optimum utilization of the time in this COVID period. And more importantly is the social responsibility. So everyone is talking about social responsibility. Social responsibility do not mean providing your e-resources or supporting information to the users. See, it is more than that. Social responsibility means, see, as a librarian, okay, as a team of your own staff, how you are helping to the people other than your students' community. Are you adopting any small group or are you going to any rural village and helping them with a mask, helping them, making them awareness about the COVID, how to live with that COVID? Okay, so these are all the social responsibility. Of course, we are contributing a fund and helping, that's the other part. But see, we need to think beyond our librarianship also. That matters a lot, and that is where we can really exhibit our skills in this corona. Okay, and everyone today is having a ML, Master degree in Library Science, PhD, JRF, everything. See, theoretically, we are acquiring all sort of an academic qualification. That's fine. Both acha hai. Okay, you are a doctorate now, fine. But today, especially in the industry, especially in the corporate sector, see what they require? They require skills of employability. तुमको क्लासिफिकेशन करने को अच्छा आते हैं बड़े बात है सो यू आर डूइंग कैटलॉगिंग फाइन ओके सो दिस आर ऑल द थिंग्स व्हिच वी हैव लर्नड फ्रॉम आवर टीचर्स वो इतना बस नहीं होता है सी व्हाट वी सी आई टेल यू द स्टूडेंट्स आफ्टर पासिंग मास्टर डिग्री और पीएचडी ज्वाइनिंग टू द कॉलेज और यूनिवर्सिटी तुम्हारा एकेडमिक क्वालिफिकेशन ओनली बेसिक रहता है सो यू नीड टू हैव एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी स्किल्स So only for a PhD, having saying that I'm a PhD scholar, I'm a net pass candidate will not work. You need to possess employability skills. Okay, what sort of employability skills that we need to possess, that we will look upon. Okay, and that is what employability means. Not be any merely academic qualification, but beyond that, maybe it is an IT skills or a technology skills or a leadership skills or attitudinal skills. There are plenty of skills of which we need to possess. Okay, so that will make us really wonderful librarian of this 21st century. And today we need to ask ourselves, see, when I'm talking more about skills, why am I speaking more about skills? Don't we have that sort of skills? Yeah, we are having. See, we need to ask here that mere possessing the school, which I said earlier also, MLS or PhD is not enough because we need to possess the skills which is desired by the corporate sector, which is desired by the higher educational institution. We need to be more of a practical knowledge rather than a theoretical knowledge. And we need to upgrade our skills that is desired in this 21st century if at all we wanted to survive in the librarianship. If we don't possess the other type of skills, maybe IT skills or practical oriented skills, definitely I will tell you our librarianship will not last for a longer. That is the reason we need to keep ourselves updated with all the latest development happening around the world and try to gain all sort of a practical knowledge to support our students and faculty with all the skills to make them really worth enough. And if you see the employment as per the India Skill Development Report, see the students who have passed Bachelor of Engineering, so BTech, so what is the percentage of employability? So you can see nearly half, means 49% of the students who have passed out their Bachelor of Engineering or a Bachelor of Technology, their employment is just 50%. Okay, if you see my MBA or a Bachelor of Arts, when you come down even for a Master of Computer Application, MCA, the employability is only a 1/4. Then where are the students who are passing master degree, possessing a PhD in library science, where they have to go? What is the trend of employability? You see, if the students of our library science do not get a job, means they may not, you know, the younger generation may not opt for library science. Why do we join for any engineering or a medical or even library science? Because we wanted a job, isn't it? Getting a job. If there is no scope for a job, means then definitely the number of intake for a master degree students in the various universities will definitely come down. See, for that, what we need to do, how we have to attract, what would be the role of a teaching faculty and what would be the role of a librarian? See, these are all the skills where we need to think beyond a librarianship. Okay. And what is the current situation in India? See, we are talking about skills. Hum bade bade baate, vada pav khate. Hum baat bahut bade bade karte hain. But practically kya chal raha hai? See, how many universities in India have employed full-time librarian? How many colleges in India have employed full-time college librarian? So I give my own instance of Karnataka. In Karnataka state, we have 28 state universities. In 28 state universities, not even a single university librarian is being appointed. We are only promoted librarians. Then see the situation. Then how can you expect the other part of an innovation or a creativity or acquiring more skills? See, this won't happen. See, for this, the government of India or the association should play an important role. Okay. See, on one side, there is a different picture. On the other side of practicality, we see a lot of, the challenges, right? And how to convert our challenges into opportunities is important. And for that, see, we need to be a very, very smart librarian. Means the librarians who are in the library, whether it's a library assistant, whether he's an assistant librarian or a deputy librarian or a university librarian, let him not worry what is his post. Okay, let us do everything in a team. Try to gain all sort of skills that is required. And these smart skills are not required just to gain myself competent. मुझे कॉम्पिटेंट करके कुछ बड़ा काम करने की जरूरती नहीं है मैं जो भी व्हाटएवर द नॉलेज आई गेन आई शुड इम्पार्ट टू माय स्टूडेंट्स माय टीचिंग फैकल्टी. आजकल क्या हो गया, बहुत शाणा बन गए, बहुत शाणातन से काम नहीं चलता. आप शाणा है तो वो स्टूडेंट्स को रीच होना, तो टीचिंग फैकल्टी को रीच होना, देयर लाइज द प्रॉब्लम. ओके, सो वी आर ऑल वेरी इंटेलिजेंट, बट इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू रीच टू अवर स्टूडेंट्स एंड द फैकल्टी, देन व्हाट इज द यूज? It's a waste, isn't it? So we need to acquire a lot of smart skills, academic, social, emotional, cognizant, language, and a lot of etiquettes are required. And how the librarian has to be play important role as a catalyst in a NAC. See, we are also more bothered about the NAC. See, here what happens, we the librarians, especially the librarians of different strata, see, we are having a 1000 mark for a NAC. And what is our role in the library? Under criteria 4, that to 4.2, library as a learning resource center, it is only a 20 marks. Okay, 20 marks out of 1000 marks. Then where is your skill? So your skill is restricted to only 20 marks? No, you have to think beyond again librarianship. You cannot confine and saying that, sir, my job is 4 criteria 4.2, that is library as a learning resource center, and only 20 marks are there. I will prepare everything data and submit to the IQSC director, and it is his lookout. If you are confining yourself only to that particular library component, then you are dead. Nahi hota hai. Like NAC mein 1000 marks hai. Don't confine yourself with only 20 marks. If you seriously go through criteria 1, criteria 2, up to criteria 7, in all the criteria, the librarian aspect is very, very important. And the teaching faculty, you know, if they are doing a criteria 1 or a criteria 2, without the help of a librarian, those criteria cannot be fulfilled. Okay, that's why the librarian has to play an important role as a catalyst. Okay. So as a catalyst and help in each and every criteria of the NAC, rather than confining himself only to the library aspect. Okay. And what is the more important today is everyone, every librarian, every younger generation, you know, so they're all, we wanted to be mere possessing a librarianship is not enough. We need to be IT savvy, technology savvy. Okay. See, my point is, maybe, you know, like senior librarians, you know, like maybe I am also one of senior librarians. See, even though you may not be aware how to know about the IT, any technological tool, but as a librarian, awareness is very important. Although practically you may not be able to install Koha, you may not be able to install DSpace. No problem. Somebody will do for you. Not an issue. But at least you need to have awareness how to use it. As a librarian, humko Google aur ek Google research karne ka jaruri nahi hai. We did not innovate or find any new classification scheme. Jaruri nahi hai. Humko kya karne ka hai? Whatever is there, we have to use it. Okay. That is how our skill matters a lot. It is not the age that matters. It is only a passion that matters for you to learn all the technological gadgets which are of a help to librarians, and in turn, that is going to help to our students and teaching faculty. That matters a lot. Okay. And when we talk about the collection, development, and organizing skills, see what is required for us. Okay. See, having a knowledge about the drone technology, it's required. See, today, where the librarianship is moving, See, the countries, you know, especially European countries, they are thinking of delivering a book through the drone technology. Okay, because now in this situation of COVID, Corona, students are not coming to the library. So people are thinking of delivering a books required by a student by using a drone technology. This drone is like, just like an aeroplane. It carries from one point of one area to another area. See, this is how people are thinking. Librarians are thinking. But where are we? See, we need to think. You know, these are the skills. You know, we need to be aware. We are not going to develop any sort of a drone technology. Try to apply it within the limitations. Okay. And now we can order this, we can make an online ordering. See, don't confine to traditional way of book ordering. Now everything has become visualized, you know, IT has come. So try to place the order by using Amazon or a Flipkart or there may be an inbuilt software wherein we can ask our publisher to integrate his catalog into our library catalog so that whenever students want any particular book which is not subscribed but it is available in the catalog, we can place the order. See, these are all the new skills that we need to develop rather than sticking on to the only the traditional skills that we possess. ये नहीं चलेगा जो हम पहले करते थे काम वही स्टाइल में हम करेंगे वो क्लास पहला ग्रुप रिक्रूटमेंट करने का मैन्युअली करना और आए के बाद क्लासिफिकेशन कैटलॉगिंग डोंट मींस सी डोंट डू दैट सी दैट स्टाइल ऑफ फंक्शनिंग नाउ वी हैव टू चेंज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ अ क्लासिफिकेशन कैटलॉगिंग हैज कम डाउन आई विल टेल यू हाउ ओके हाउ वी कैन रियली रिड्यूस आवर टाइम इन ऑर्गेनाइजिंग Now there are a lot of books are cataloging. See, now most of them hardly, you know, in any university or a college, very few staff are there. Okay, 3 or 4. We cannot do all the activities. Now for classification also, we wanted one separate staff. Now that is not required. I do feel, you know, there are some lot of already your e-granth, your especially agricultural librarians, you know, they have made it their union catalog or. E-grant and everything perfect compared to other type of a state university librarians. Agriculture university librarians really have done a wonderful job. So this is from the InfoLibNet. You have a e-grant also. There all automatically whenever you purchase any particular book, rather than classifying it, see whether that already somebody has made a classification or a cataloging. So try to use the same classification number and put it rather than scratching your head. See, why I'm telling, because you are having a very limited staff. You have to concentrate more on marketing of a library services, okay, rather than doing only traditional activity. Everything we are doing behind the screen. Behind the screen kaam kare to nahi chalega. We wanted to come to the front end, okay. Even for you know cataloging also, if there are already bibliographical records are already available, so why can't we import that bibliographical record into our catalog rather than again typing the same thing and wasting our time? See, these are all the techniques, you know, skills which we need to understand, okay. And I know majority of the librarians are already doing it. See, we have a catalog, we can borrow, import the bibliographical records with the compatibility of Z39.50 and do it. Okay, and what is the strength of our library? So our strength of a library lies in the fact that we have everything. We have everything, we have all technology, but what is your challenge? The utilization. How many students are using, how many faculty are using, and so that is where, you know, we are lacking today. We need to be more of an innovative in nature and try to see that even though students are not coming or faculty are not coming, you have a library, you have to make a move. You have to make a move of electronic library to the doorstep of users. That is the strength of your librarianship. We have a remote access technology. We have a electronic collection. We have a social networking tools. Make use of all those things and do it. Right? See, of course, there is no need for you to tell about the consortia. And Professor Veeranjalu is one of the most authoritative and a senior librarian and a very knowledgeable personality. You have developed your SIRA consortia. You have a plenty of open access resources that you try to promote it. Those skill of searching is also important. Okay. So you have to help the students and the faculty, not just providing the link. Rather than that, you have to tell the search strategy involved in finding how to use the JGate. That search skills you need to concentrate rather than providing a link of HERA consortia are providing a link to free resources is of not much value, rather than you need to concentrate upon the training. Okay, there are plenty of e-resources available. There are a lot of learning management tools are available, that the one which we are doing it. Okay, I know the time is shortage. Time thoda kam chal raha hai. So I will not be I'll be touching upon the important things only. So talking about sensor technology. See, one important policy is like, where this is only the new thing which I'm trying to concentrate. Shelf-ready acquisition policy. See, I wanted to give one example. Especially in the foreign countries, you know, foreign library, what is happening, you know, when we place the order for a books, what they are doing? See, when we place the order for the books, they are classifying, they are cataloging, they are pasting the RFID tag, and ready-made jacket they are sending to the library. Means there is no need for actioning, or there is no need for classification, there is no need for cataloging and data entry in our software. Everything is done by the publisher itself. So that's a trend. Why can't we think of, okay? See, these are all the new skill, you know, that we can really think of to reduce the traditional work. And so we can concentrate more upon marketing of library resources. So that is a skill where we really work upon. Evidence-based acquisition. You see, there are some big libraries. Of course, there are chota-mota library. Hamara farka library mein jyada paisa nahi hai. There are libraries that are spending crores together of amount. Okay, so there crore means 1 crore, 2 crore. See, what if the evidence-based acquisition means here? What is required? That only you procure it. So this is a new concept. You integrate all the publisher catalog in your web OPAC, in your OPAC, whichever is required by the faculty or students. Then only those things you purchase it, rather than purchasing the lot. So don't go for purchasing of Springer, Taylor and Francis at a bulk. You think of purchasing a book, select, the user will select and you procure it. See, these sort of things, you know, if not in total, little bit we can think of these sort of skills. There are a lot of things are there. Dr. Kadam, I think I'm running short of time now. There are a lot
sir,
of...
Please, yeah. Sir. Continue, sir.
Sir, you may take your own time, please.
Okay. Let me miss, because I know that yes, should not. Well, I thought of giving a lot of examples, but little bit, whatever is important that I'm trying to concentrate. See, we all talk about resource discovery tool. The EBSCO is there. ALMA is international. EBSCO is Indian based. It's also international only. How many people, how many libraries can afford to have this sort of EBSCO? Not possible. See, it's a very costly year. हमको छोटा मोटा लाइब्रेरी को ऐसा रिसोर्स डिस्कवरी टूल बोलने से अच्छा लगता है. मैं जो बोल रहा हूँ बड़े बात वो अच्छा लगता है, बट प्रैक्टिकली इट वेरी डिफिकल्ट है. सी व्हाट वी कैन थिंक, सी मेक यूज ऑफ योर ओन जेगेट, मेक इट वेरी कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव. ओके, एंड यूज दैट, इट्स अ फ्री वन, रादर देन सी इफ यू हैव मनी एवरीथिंग यू कैन गो फॉर EBSCO और रिसोर्स डिस्कवरी टूल और ALMA डिस्कवरी टूल. इफ यू डोंट हैव, मेक यूज ऑफ द एग्जिस्टिंग जेगेट, best part. Okay, so this is how we can make use of, this is actually brief, one of the finest, if at all where it is affordable, go for it. Okay, Xlibris is the ultimate resource discovery tool, right? And of course, these are all, you know, the self-issue, self-return, we are all well aware about RFID technology, and hopefully, see, these are all the things, you know, I don't want to repeat again. This is only an RFID technology, wherever, whenever a library is closed. So this technology facilitates us to have a deposit. Means we can return the book at any time, 24/7, and automatically she gets a receipt. And as a student or a faculty, directly he can go to the library and he or she can borrow the book without asking the librarian. Physical library is not required, because we have a RFID technology. There is a self-ready issue and return systems are there. So these are all the other technologies are available which we can make use of. I think these are all, we are all well aware about these RFID gates, wherein, you know, which will help for a security control. Not only that, there is a very recently one other technology it has come. See, whenever you enter, we all think that this is used for only finding the detecting the theft of the book. No, that is there. In addition to that, so very recently we are going to implement in Gulbarga University, the moment students enter into the magnetic gate, automatically his picture will be captured. Means we wanted attendance, how many students have entered, how many students have gone. That we wanted statistics. We don't want them to show their identity card and press to the thing. No, that magnetic, that RFID gate should take care. The moment the student enter, it is recorded. One student entered. Okay, second student, third student. This is the statistics we are planning. This is a new trend. Of course, most of the people may be using a different type of ID card, a swap thing. So that's fine. This is another technology which has been integrated in RFID. Okay, the moment you enter, you will be recorded. So that's the strength of a thing we can think beyond. Okay, jo normal karte hai, unko thoda hatke karna, wo hai librarianship. Okay, of course, this is a digital library assistant. If you are affordable, going for a RFID. See, what is the bigger challenge for a librarian is, mera khud library, mera Gulbarga University library, 2-3 lakh book hai. अगर कोई यूजर आके मुझे पूछेगा भैया मुझे ये कैटलॉग में तुम्हारा पास है, इट इज अवेलेबल, इट इज शोइंग दैट इट इज अवेलेबल इन योर कैटलॉग, कैन यू गेट मी दैट बुक, मैं अगर जाता हूँ रैक पर तो मिलता नहीं है, तो अभी वो स्टूडेंट क्या बोलेगा, अरे पागल आदमी इतना बड़ा बात बोलता है, जो बुक मुझे चाहिए वो तुम्हारा पास नहीं मिल रहा है, क्या करूं, तुम्हारा पास तुमको यूजीसी पे स्केल मिल रहा है, एक बुक नहीं दे सकते क्या? दिस आर ऑल चैलेंजेस, सी हाउ वी कैन रिजॉल्व इट. See, RFID technology is there, digital library assistant is there. You type the action number or a title and go to the racks and it will tell you, main idhar hu, retrieve karo bolke. See, that's how, you know, these are technology which are helping us. Okay, of course, I know it may be costly. Think of such technology. Think of applying, using more of our skills. There are certain people, so we are talking about knowledge management. There are few librarians, there are few attenders in the library. They are so sharp, so talented that they know where that particular book is located. See, that's a skill we need to utilize in our library, isn't it? See, there are a lot of skills, and this is one of the beautiful virtual library of Gulbarga University, comprising of 100 computer systems under network environment, using Wi-Fi, all sort of a consortia, DSpace installation, institution repository is there, remote access through Shibboleth, we are doing it. Okay, lot of indigenous content is also being put on the server, and the major problem I tell you, see, I saw bade lab banne se kuch humko, there are a lot of challenges also. So you are opening for 1 year, everything bada pakka chalega. Baad mein, you have to go for a maintenance. We have to have a, think of maintenance. That's a skill. Okay, you have to make a provision, separate provision for a budget. And we are having this thing, we have to learn also. We have to learn how to use it. Okay, we may not be good in installing the server. Okay, Windows NT, hum install kar nahi sakte. Agar hum main nahi kar sakta, aap log kar sakte. Jo bhi advanced hai, अगर हमको नहीं आता है तो एटलीस्ट हाउ टू यूज इट वो सीखना चाहिए ना. सो दैट वी हैव टू लर्न इट. ओके, देयर आर सर्टेन स्किल्स ऑफ नेटवर्किंग, यू नो, बेसिक थिंग्स एज अ लाइब्रेरियन वी नीड टू लर्न, इफ नॉट इन टोटल. सी, दिस आर ऑल द थिंग्स, यू नो, व्हिच वी नीड टू लर्न, एंड ऑलवेज वी हैव दिस वन. सी, अरे व्हेनेवर समबडी सेज डू दिस वर्क, वी हैव 100 reasons टू अवॉइड द वर्क, बट देयर इज 1 good reason टू डू द वर्क. हम हर जो भी बोलेगा वो लेकर आओ, सर मुझे, मेरे पास ये नहीं है, मेरे पास वो नहीं है. रीजंस तो बहुत है काम करने के लिए, मगर काम करने के लिए पॉजिटिवनेस एटीट्यूड चाहिए, दैट्स मोर इम्पोर्टेंट. ओके, तो देर आर वर्चुअल रेफरेंस सर्विसेज, देर आर अ क्वेश्चन पॉइंट, हाउ मेनी लाइब्रेरी वेबसाइट्स हैव बीन इंटीग्रेटेड विद द आस्क ए लाइब्रेरियन और चैटिंग सर्विसेज. ये छोटे छोटे है चीज, हम कर सकते हैं. लोग यूजर यूज करने दो नहीं करने दो, उनका उनका ऊपर छोड़ेंगे. बट एज अ लाइब्रेरियन, व्हाई कांट यू इंटीग्रेट वन क्वेश्चन सर्वे? ओके, व्हेनेवर यू अंडर कोविड, यू नो, अंडर कोरोना, स्टूडेंट इज नॉट कमिंग, सिटिंग एट हिज होम, ही कैन गो टू यूर वेबसाइट एंड देर इज अ चैट बॉट, देर इज अ क्वेश्चन पॉइंट, ही कैन गिव अ क्वेश्चन, आई नीड अ बुक ऑन दिस, आई नीड अ इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑन दिस. व्हेन दे सेंड टू यू, इट विल कम टू लाइब्रेरियन बॉक्स. ओके, यू सेंड द इन्फॉर्मेशन. ये स्मॉल स्मॉल थिंग्स है, बट वी आर नॉट डूइंग. ऑफ कोर्स कॉर्पोरेट लाइब्रेरी बड़ा बड़ा इसमें करते हैं, व्हाई कांट वी डू इट? इट कॉस्ट में पैसा ज्यादा नहीं लगता है ये छोटे छोटे काम करने के लिए. ओके, ट्राई टू हैव अ क्वेश्चन पॉइंट, अरे आस्क ए लाइब्रेरियन, सो दैट वी कैन थिंक ऑफ एंड सी द वन टेक्नोलॉजी दैट इज बीइंग डेवलप्ड इन अदर पार्ट ऑफ अ कंट्री इज कॉल्ड अ चैट बॉट. व्हाट इज दैट चैट बॉट? See, here they are using this chatbot technology not only for a library, for university they are using it. Even if the students or the faculty who are not coming, they may be a remote corner. They go to this chatbot technology and they type, I want to seek admission for MBA. I want to seek admission for master degree in library science. What I should do? So the robot will come and tell you, okay, gentlemen, you want to do admission for in our university? Okay, what is your eligibility? You go to this website, go to this contact. This is the fees you have to pay. These are all the certificates required. Everything will be dealt by that robotic technology called chatbot. See, they are applying for a university as a whole. Okay, and this is the same thing. It is also being applied for a library. See, if at least our knowledge rehna chahiye humko. Abhi hum adopt karne ka position nahi hai. I know the situation where we are prevailing in India. Aisa colleges like both colleges bhi hai, both university bhi hai. Unka paas acha baithne ke liye jagah nahi hai. Okay, hum bolte bade idhar. Bolne mein kya jata hai, hai na? See, hamara paas chair baithne ke liye, especially colleges, we don't have a proper racks. We don't have a proper chairing stairs. Reading room. Hai reading room. Humka problem to rehta hai yaar. Problem rehne do. Magar at least you need to have a knowledge. Knowledge gain karo. Skill update karo. Whenever it is possible, your skill should not get wasted. It should reach to your user. That is important. वो सब हम पंडित है इधर ही मेरे पास रखे तो कुछ फायदा नहीं है. वो स्टूडेंट को हेल्प होना, तुम्हारा फैकल्टी को हेल्प होना, दैट इज द इम्पोर्टेंस. ओके, रिमोट एक्सेस इज देयर, यू आर ऑल अवेयर, सोशल नेटवर्क है. एंड हियर सी, देयर आर मोबाइल एप्लीकेशंस, मोबाइल बेस्ड एप्लीकेशंस आर देयर. व्हाई कांट वी थिंक ऑफ डेवलपिंग ए मोबाइल एप्लीकेशन फॉर अवर लाइब्रेरी, फॉर अवर रिसोर्सेस? ओके, एंड देयर आर सम रेडीमेड things are available. See, because students nowadays, everyone is using a mobile. So National Digital Library of India, they have developed a mobile app. Okay, so you ask your students to go to the Play Store of your mobile, type NDLI, install that NDLI software in the mobile. Whenever they want, they can access the NDLI. It contains nearly 3.8 crore of learning course material, which is not only confined to agriculture, but all the subjects. Nothing is better than something, na? 3.8 crore. Kisko bolte hai yaar? Bahut ho gaya. See, this sort of a thing we can do. There is a platform called Copy Kitab, purely meant for competitive examination. It's a mobile application which we can subscribe very cheaper rate. And also think of subscribing a Mint book. So this is another publisher. Everyone provides nowadays mobile application. Mobile based applications are being provided. You can ask your students or a faculty to download the application from their mobile. Okay, and start using it. See, these are all small things we can do it. I think one important aspect I want to cover, then wind up, because time is running, especially for a librarian. So everyone, you know, like wanted here to publish a हम लाइब्रेरी. अरे आपका टीचिंग फैकल्टी उस स्कोपस में हाई इंडेक्स में पब्लिश करता है, एग्रीकल्चरल साइंटिस्ट बड़ा लोग रहते हैं वो लोग पब्लिश करते हैं, हम लाइब्रेरियन भी कहाँ पब्लिश करना पड़ेगा ना, क्योंकि वी आर ऑल्सो ऑन पार विथ टीचर. सो उसके लिए हमारा मास कितना है, हम एपीएस स्कोर कैसे कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं? ओके, अभी हम क्या होता है नॉर्मली, हम लाइब्रेरी, मेरा खुद एग्जाम्पल बोलता हूँ, हम नॉर्मली अभी 15 साल तक हमने क्या किया, 7-8 लोगों का नाम डाले कॉन्फ्रेंस पेपर में, आर्टिकल में पब्लिश करे. अभी मालूम हो रहा है कि फर्स्ट ऑथर यू विल गेट 70% ऑफ द मार्क, सेकंड ऑथर मिलता है 30%. अभी मेरा प्रमोशन नहीं होता है, क्योंकि हम बोलेंगे मेरा 50 आर्टिकल है. तेरा पास 50 आर्टिकल है भैया, वो कौन सा पेपर कहाँ पब्लिश किया, हा? और कितना ऑथर्स है, ऑल दिस मैटर्स. ओके, स्पेशली फॉर प्रमोशन, राइट? सो लेट अस सी हाउ एक्चुअली वी कैन कैलकुलेट द एपीएस स्कोर, राइट? ऑफकोर्स यू हैव टू पब्लिश स्टार्ट आर्टिकल. See, now you are helping to the faculty, fine, but you need to publish your article. Maybe you are a PhD scholar. Okay, you may there may be some librarians who are doing a PhD. You need to understand how you have to publish an article. Okay, or out of curiosity, you have to make some sort of presentation, right? So these are all, you know, like publishing means a lot of things are there. So you have to see that one general format of writing any research article for a librarian, only for a librarian. कभी भी क्या करने का, टाइटल ऑफ द आर्टिकल शुड बी वेरी फैंसी. ओके, लुक फॉर अ फैंसी टाइटल. फैंसी बोले तो अंडरस्टैंड भी होना पड़ेगा, करेंट भी रहना पड़ेगा. देन फॉलोड बाय अ ऑथर, फॉलोड बाय अ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट, After that, Kaisa Raina, it should be a gist, followed by a keyword. Then you start with the introduction. Don't forget to write a review of literature, both important hai, ek article likhne ke liye, and objectives. We should be very specific, not general nahi chalta hai. Methodology that you follow, what sort of a tool you have used, what sort of a statistical package you are using, that you need to concentrate, and results and discussion, conclusion, and more important is references. Okay, see, there are so many things for which we need to concentrate. Now, the most important aspect for a librarian is, yaar mujhe abhi promotion milta hai, nahi to samjho abhi maine I have completed my master degree and passed NET, I want to join as a assistant librarian, mujhe books ke liye kaisa karna padega, mera book publish kare to kahan publish kare to mera scoring kitna badhta hai, and as per the UGC latest notification, okay, so as per UGC latest notification, if you publish a book, then so for a national book it is a 10 marks 10 mark hota hai, international book 12 marks. If you are contributing a chapter in any edited book means, then it is a 8 marks. That is a national book. If you are contributing in edited book na, especially for a international level, they will give 5 marks. Okay, then see, these are all the things. Then even for development of a e-content, if you are developing any learning course material, okay, for that also, if you are developing any course material for a library science, because agricultural university mein, there is a one separate component you have to teach as a librarian, you have to teach to your students, isn't it? For a bachelor degree, there is a separate units are there which a librarian has to teach, and it is a librarian who knows that knowledge, you know. So for that, if you develop any e-content, you will get some 5 marks, okay, like that. Research guidance, PhD, agar if you are guide, then for a PhD you get 10 marks. Yeah, and if at all your students have submitted a PhD thesis, it is not yet awarded, then you will get 5 marks. For MPhil award of your student, you will get 2 marks. Similarly, for a research project, if you take any research project which is of more than 10 lakh, so you will get 5 marks, right? Okay, if it is less than a 10 lakh major project, you will get 2 marks only. Suppose say if there are 2 persons, Kadam and one more person, if jointly they have done a major research project, then how much marks each will get? So 10 marks means 5 marks Kadam will get, another person, co-investigator, will get 5 marks, 50%, 50-50. Okay, that's how it will be there. Even if you are getting any fellowship like a IFLA fellowship or a Commonwealth fellowship, you have a 7 marks. Indian fellowship, you get a 5 marks. Okay, and more important is like an invited lecture or a conference paper, if it is a full text paper, na? So for an international, you get 5 marks. For a national conference paper, full text, you get 3 marks, right? And for abroad, international, you have again 7. Okay. Then, more importantly, everyone who wanted to publish the article, especially in the UGC CARE, are a NAS accredited journal, right? So here also, you should be very cautious. If you are publishing in a journal where there is no impact factor, means you will get marks, but thoda kam milega. Especially without any impact factor means, if you are publishing a journal where it is not approved by UGC or a NAS, you will get 5 marks. If there is an impact factor of less than 1 impact factor, then you will get 10 marks. If the impact factor of a journal is between 1 and 2, you will get 15, then 20, then 25. If the impact factor is more than 10, you will get a marks of 30. Okay, so these are all the scoring is available, but here you need to understand that if you are writing a journal article with your paper, your co-author, the first author will get 70%, second author will, person will get 30%. If you get 30 marks for one paper, then the first author will get 21 marks, second author will get 9 marks. Okay, so you need to be cautious about even the principal author, okay, who is the first author and the second author. If you want to have a sharing of equal marks, means the first author as a principal author and the second author should be a corresponding author, so that he will also get 70%. Okay, there is a technique. Okay, so first author 70%, second author, if you become a corresponding author, then you will get again 70% only. Okay, try to have these are all the skills, you know, which win. There are a lot of skills are available, you know, H index, everything. I think it will be taken care by other people, other resource person tomorrow, day after tomorrow. I have a lot of things to tell, but let me just not to concentrate much upon the so many other factors. Okay, व्हाट इज इंपैक्ट, दिस आर ऑल स्किल रिक्वायर्ड. सी नॉर्मली क्या हो जाते हैं, हर फैकल्टी पूछे एच इंडेक्स क्या है. ओके, सो यू नीड टू नो हाउ टू कैलकुलेट. सो वेब ऑफ साइंस देता है, स्कोपस देता है, अरे यार वो ऑटोमेटिक कैलकुलेट करता है, देता है. आप लोगों को क्या, आप लोगों को मालूम नहीं होता क्या कैसा कैलकुलेशन करना. यू नीड टू लर्न दैट एच इंडेक्स मैनुअली, यू शुड लर्न. सो ये क्या, दिस इज अ वन स्किल. ये जरूरी नहीं है सर हमारे लिए वेब ऑफ साइंस देता है बोले तो छोड़ दो. But you need to know how you have to calculate H index for a MP impact factor. There are formulas are there which you need to do, and you have to learn the skills of helping our students and faculty with a research gate or a ORF, how to create an ORFID ID. Okay, there are plenty of things. These you need to help to your students. For that you need to gain the knowledge. You know the skills are required. Tumhara library science kitna padhe aap 2 saal mein, wo jyada kaam ko thoda kaam ko aata hai. Wo jyada aap प्रैक्टिकल सीखना पड़ेगा. ओके, दिस आर ऑल द स्पेस अदर थिंग्स वी कैन डू. सो विच दिस आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू, दिस इज अ रिच रिसर्च प्रोडक्टिविटी. आई हैव नॉट सीन मच ऑफ द एग्रीकल्चर यूनिवर्सिटी लाइब्रेरी डूइंग दिस प्रोडक्टिविटी प्रोफाइल. एंड डॉक्टर कदम हैज सेड ही विल बी डूइंग इट वेरी शॉर्टली. एंड हियर इज दी, वॉट इज दिस, दिस इज अ कुंडली, कुंडली ऑफ यूर यूनिवर्सिटी. तुम्हारा यूनिवर्सिटी में कितना फैकल्टी है, कितना लोग पब्लिश करे, हाउ मेनी पीपल, हाउ मेनी फैकल्टी हैव एच इंडेक्स, ओके व्हाट इज द इंपैक्ट फैक्टर, टोटल कितना जर्नल आर्टिकल्स है, टोटल कितना कॉन्फ्रेंस पेपर है, एवरीथिंग विल कम अंडर वन अम्ब्रेला. दैट इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ दिस IRINS डाटाबेस. ओके, सो वी नीड टू हैव अ स्किल अबाउट लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स. मोर देन दैट, अवर कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स इज इंपॉर्टेंट, लीडरशिप स्किल्स इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट इज मार्केटिंग स्किल. ये जरूरी है आज के तारीख पर, मार्केटिंग स्किल्स इज वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट. चुप सब हमारे पास रख लेके, और मेरे पास इलेक्ट्रॉनिक रिसोर्स है, मेरे पास डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी सब कुछ है, मगर यूज करने वाले नहीं है. तुम अंदर 4 walls ऑफ लाइब्रेरी सिटिंग एज ए लाइब्रेरियन टॉकिंग विद द टेलीफोन नहीं चलेगा. यू हैव टू कम बियॉन्ड हाउ टू मार्केट यूर प्रोडक्ट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड आई हैव सीन वन इंपॉर्टेंट आस्पेक्ट इज एटीट्यूड स्किल, एटीट्यूडनल स्किल. आजकल क्या हो गया, ज्यादा ज्यादा शानतन जान को खतरा, शानस ज्यादा हो गए. अरे आई एम अ चीफ लाइब्रेरियन बोले तो क्या बड़े बन गए, नहीं. यूअर एटीट्यूड ऑल्सो मैटर्स अ लॉट. सी यू हैव टू बी अप्रोचेबल यार, जो भी आते हैं आने के लिए बुलाओ, आ जाओ भैया, अंदर हो, बैठो बैठो, क्या चाहिए, वो प्यार से बात करना पड़ेगा. तुम बहुत ब्रिलियंट है, बहुत स्ट्रिक्ट है तो क्या करने का, स्ट्रिक्ट है, इंटेलिजेंट है, वो दूसरे को हेल्प नहीं है तो बेकार. That is an attitudinal skill that we need to possess, right? Like this, there are hundreds of things which we are there, and there are a lot of fellowships are there which I may not touch upon, but IFLA is there, and very recently, you know, Mendeley, like Scopus has having some accreditation program that's called Mendeley Certification Program, and they give a Scopus certification for librarians. They also give some training program under a resource database management library academy from the Scopus. These three are from the Scopus only. Contact them and make use of. In addition to that, there are so many fellowships are there. Okay, see fellowship. ये जरूरी नहीं कि अगर मैंने IFLA है, Commonwealth है, तो मैं शाना बोल के जरूरी नहीं है. तुम्हारा पास जो दिमाग है वो दूसरे स्टूडेंट्स को कितना अप्लाई करते हैं, फैकल्टी को कितना अप्लाई करते हैं, इंस्टीट्यूशन के लिए कितना बिल्डअप करते हैं, वो इंपॉर्टेंट रहता है. Okay, so finally to conclude, so we have to survive in this very difficult situation wherein people are talking about what is the necessity of a librarian. Librarian ke jaruri kya hai? Okay, everything is electronic. वो बोलते हैं, पागल लोग बोलते हैं कि लाइब्रेरी का जरूरी नहीं है, मगर हम लोग शाना है ना. वी हैव ऑल द स्किल्स, यू नो, वी हैव द स्किल्स टू मैनेज अवर लाइब्रेरी, नॉट ट्रेडिशनली बट इलेक्ट्रॉनिकली विथ यूजिंग लॉट ऑफ आईटी गैजेट्स. दैट्स अ स्किल. ओके, दैट्स अ स्किल. इफ यू से आई एम अ ओल्ड मैन, आई कांट डू दैट, अरे यार तुम मत करो यार, तुम्हारा सपोर्टिंग स्टाफ को बोलो, यूज, लेट देम यूज इट. सी अल्टीमेटली वी हैव टू बी आईटी सभी पर्सन. हमको फिर लाइब्रेरियनशिप इज नॉट कन्फाइंड टू वन पर्टिकुलर डिपार्टमेंट. वी डील विद एंटायर गमत ऑफ नॉलेज. एवरी साइंस सब्जेक्ट इज अवर प्रॉपर्टी, सोशल साइंस हमारा प्रॉपर्टी, ह्यूमैनिटीज लैंग्वेज हमारा प्रॉपर्टी, बिकॉज वी डील विद ऑल द सब्जेक्ट. बट टीचिंग फैकल्टी क्या होता है, ही डील्स ओनली विद पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट, बट वी डील विद एंटायर गमत ऑफ नॉलेज. एंड वी नीड टू बी वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग, नॉट मियरली इन यूर लाइब्रेरी साइंस स्किल्स, बट IT skills, management skills, attitudinal skills, marketing skills, and leadership skills, and what not. So these we need to develop. then only really we can survive on this librarianship in the coming days. And finally, I wanted to tell one concluding remark. Don't expect your vice chancellor, don't expect your faculty to praise you. Oh, ye nahi bolega, hey, tu kadam bahut acha kaam karta hai, balki don't expect it. You do your job, yaar. Tumko pagar mil raha hai, kaam karo bas. Logo gaale diye to bhi chinta mat karo, acha bole to bhi chinta mat karo. As a librarian, you do the job, you show your innovation, you acquire skills and do the work. That is the simplicity of a librarianship. Okay, don't expect anything from that. So that's what, with this, I acknowledge and thank Dr. Kadam and entire team of RD and also my friend Veeranjuliji for giving me this opportunity to be part of this national webinar. Thank you very much.
Now I would like to, Dr. Kanpal sir, I hand over you, please, if there are questions, please.
Thank you, Kalaji. Hello.
I would like to I would like to Jange sir, yes. Please close door.
Okay. Yeah.
First of all, I am congratulate to Dr. Suresh Jange ji for nice presentation and motivated speech of the all the librarians. Thanks for a lot for the nice presentation, sir. Sir, that we have received the two questions from Leela Dhar. They are asking, do you think the RFID is proceed for librarian theft?
See, normally RFID, even a manual security guard also will help to have the control over the theft. But this is only, you know, those who can afford it are by using RFID technology. RFID tags are there. So if they have embedded in the books, it will definitely help you to protect. Okay, protect from the theft.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you. Next question is asking from Ranjita. What is the procedure for register to Google Scholar?
Okay, I got
and
it.
Get the citation and
Index. Actually, that is my very closed topic, but the next research person might be taking it. I would have shown practically how to create that one also. Madam, you have to have your Gmail account first. You have to have your Gmail account. That's the first thing. Then you can create a Google Scholar citation. Okay, if you need any particular, you know, personal one-to-one contact, take my number and a mobile, keep in touch. I'll ensure you that within one hour, we can create that Google Scholar citation for you.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you. Okay. You have nice and quick answer for the questions. The mic hand over to the Dr. Kailash Tandel. This is the organizing secretary for this program. Thank you, Lalji. You are
okay.
Giving me an opportunity for the asking the question.
Thank you.
Like that, Jange sir. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. I would like to request Harish Tripathi. If you have any comments, Tripathi sir, please unmute your mic.
Hello. Dr. Suresh Jage has a very excellent presentation. He defined smart skills in a very smart way. Smart skills consist of ICT skills, API skills, communication skills, leadership skills, design support skills, marketing skills, technical skills. There are many skills he mentioned in his presentation. And at last, he mentioned that we should have professional ethics. So I personally think that if we have the professional ethics, we can manage all skills in a smart way.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And congratulations to Dr. Suresh Jage. Thank you.
Okay, I would like to request Dr. Balwant Singh. Balwant Singh, can you hear me? Hello, Dr. Balwant Singh. I think he is not here. Okay, I would like to request Santoshji. Santoshji, if you want to do the comment, any comment, Dr. Santosh. Hello, Dr. Santosh. Dr. Santosh, unmute your mic. Acha. Now, we are going to normally word of thanks. Good afternoon to one and all. Honorable Vice Chancellor of Vasantrao Nayak Marathawada Krishi Vidyapeeth Parbhani, and today's function chairman, Dr. Ashok Dhawan sir. Respected Dr. Urmila Thakur, former professor, SP University, Vallabh Vidyanagar, Gujarat, and chief guest of the today functions. Respected Dr. K. Viranjalu sir, president of the ALDI and guest of honor of the today's function. Dr. Suresh Zange is our first guest speaker, and he gave a nice presentation here, sir. Dr. Suresh Zange, sir.
Thank you.
Then respected dignitaries, senior professionals, and our dear panelists, Dr. K. N. Kanpal sir, Dr. Harish Tripathi sir, Dr. C. K. Patel sir, Dr. Vandana Jadhav sir, Dr. Kalyan, Dr. Rakesh, Mr. Rakesh Dimmer, Ms. Yasoda Negi madam, Dr. Balwant Singh, and our dear participants. One of the first day, this is the National Faculty Development Program. It is my proud to give the word of thanks on behalf of Navsari Agriculture University, Vasantrao Nayak Marathawada Krishi Vidyapeeth, and ALDI. Today, our National Faculty Development Program topics, you so see know, sowing seed of knowledge to library information professional, and it is my pleasure to deliver the word of thanks behalf of Navsari Agriculture University and also Vasantrao Nayak Krishi Vidyapeeth and ALDI. First, I would like to heartily thank to Vice Chancellor of Vasantrao Nayak Krishi Vidyapeeth Parbhani and Chairman of the today functions, Dr. K. Dhawan sir, for his inspiring inaugural speech here. Thank you, Dr. Ashok Dhawan sir. I also would like to extend a special thank to today Chief Guest Dr. Urmila Thakur, a former professor and head Library and Information Science Department, a well-known SP University in Gujarat, for his wonderful guidance and informative keynote address. This was an extremely informative and enjoyable and valuable. Thank you, madam. I would like to extend a special thanks to Dr. K. Viranjalu sir for her excellent support. He always guiding to us. I also would like to thank Dr. Suresh Zange sir. He delivered his guest lecture is very dynamic and very knowledgeable. We take a lot of knowledge from his lectures. Thank you, Dr. Suresh Zange sir, for accepting our invitations and present here. Thank you very much. I also thank you, sir, for providing your valuable time and kind support. I would like to thank Dr. K. N. Kanpal and Harish Tripathi, Rakesh Timber, Santosh sir, and his team. I think Jadhav madam, and then Zore is their consultant technical support. I would also like to thank organizer, my colleagues, Dr. Santosh, and my dearest friend Santosh Kadam, for his support me in the this organize of National Faculty Development Program. Dr. Santosh, I am very thankful you. And last but not least, I thank to all lovely participants from the different part of the India who actively participate in this national level faculty development training program. And I also thankful my Vice Chancellor, Dr. S.R. Chaudhary sir, and our registrar. And I thankful to all our ALDI barriers and ALDI members teams. And I would like to thanks to who is supporting me in the inside this program. Thank you very much. Thank you for accepting our invitations, and thank you for the participant here. Thank you very much. Yes, Santosh, do you want? Hello, Santosh. Santosh is not there. Thank you, Suresh Zange sir. Hello. Thank you very much. Yes, sir. Yes, Santoshi, are you there? Okay, okay. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And tomorrow we will start 11 a.m. So I would like to all participate to join in the June program in the 11 o'clock. And we also sending the previews national level faculty development training program certificate in today. And I think all participate, I would like to all participate. They will receive his and her certificates during the weeks. And thank you very much to all. And I think I will I'm going to close the today first day faculty development program. Can I close?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you to all.
Bye.
Okay.